You may be thinking, oh, it's another generic Razer guide. Nah, in this video, I'll be discussing the true endgame build for Razer, team compositions, and how to use them efficiently. Welcome to the guide on Razer, an Electro-type DPS god. First, let's get started with his skills. His basic attack is really what makes him really good. Razer has an insanely high DPS that comes from his basic attack, which synergizes amazingly well with his Q, meaning you don't have to wait for cooldowns to start demolishing enemies. You don't need your E, you don't really need your Q to do damage. His fourth hit on his basic string has a nice multiplier, but it is really slow and has a long knockback. So in my opinion, I would only do the first three hits and either jump or dodge to reset the animation leg. His E skill is pretty awesome. I rarely see this mentioned, but if you quick tap E, you get a sigil with a max of 3 sigils, and each sigil gives him an extra 20% energy recharge rate, which is massive, so technically 60% recharge rate if you stack it 3 times. If you want to swap him out or give him instant energy, hold the E skill and it will cash in all the sigils, giving you 5 energy each. Also, holding E is basically an AoE nuke, which does electro damage. And here's his Q. Oh my god, his Q is nutty. Basically summons a wolf shikigami. Not only does it give your basic attack more attack speed, but your wolf ghost boy adds electro damage on top of it, and it's like a percentage off your basic attack. It doesn't change your damage to electro, but it adds an extra damage line which scales off your basic hit. Also, activating it pops off a mini E AoE, resets your actual E. And if you swap Razer with his Q active, you get some refund energy as well. So now we know two things. His basic attack is nutty, especially with his Q applied, and his electro damage with the E reset is kind of bonkers for burst. So how can we take advantage of this? Well, there's two ways to build him. Pure physical damage for the basic attack spam, or electro damage. Here is my personal build on him. I run 4-piece Gladiator for this effect specifically, 35% more damage on his basic. With this set, the best possible main stats would be attack percentage, physical percentage, and then crit damage percentage. In a future video, I'll talk about why stacking all attack percent is weaker than this combo here. But essentially, would you rather have, like, for example, 2x more damage or 2.5x more damage, or would you just want 200 to 300 more attack? Obviously, you want the 2.5 extra more damage, and that's off of critting and the high critical damage. This build also relies on critting a lot, of course, since we're scaling up his crit damage. So end game, you want crit rate in his substats, and if you're just chilling, just enjoying the game, not grinding hard, you can sub crit damage for crit chance for more reliability on his main stat helm. So for the physical build, the most important substats would be crit rate, crit damage, then attack percent. For the weapon, I am running the craftable Eminus. It has great base stats and a attack percent, and it has a really nice effect that can proc off your crits as well. So that's kind of my secret in these flex videos. If you see like 10k, 11k, 12k procs, that's a crit on the Eminus proc. Wolf's Gravestone from Gacha, which is a 5-star, and that's probably the best weapon for him. The Battle Pass weapon is also a good option for him since it has a crit rate base. Basically forces you to keep Razer in all the time, which you might be doing, so it is it's a pretty nice option for him there. And then the second build is going Electro Damage. So you want the purple numbers instead of the white numbers. And so the 4-piece set I would recommend is the Thundering Fury. It provides electro damage on the 2-piece and a huge reaction damage bonus. Unfortunately, the reaction damage doesn't scale off your crit or crit damage. The electro percent damage is already insanely high. So the main stats would look like attack percent, electro percent, and then crit damage. Why crit damage again? Because all of your electro damage can crit. All the purple numbers can crit except for the reactions, meaning your EQE combo will be the fattest burst you'll ever see. If you want some free-to-play options for the builds, I would recommend mixing 2-piece sets like the Berserker set for more crit chance. You have the Bloodstained Chivalry for a nice 25% physical bonus damage if you want to build him for basic attacks, or you can opt out for the 2-2 attack percent bonus as a two set. You can get another one from Sovereigns or something like that. Now, number three, let's talk about his constellations. 1-6 here, okay, free damage, that's nice. 2-6, this is also nice. It gives you extra crit if enemies are below 30%. The 4-6 constellation here is probably the most important one. If you quick tap E, it applies 15% defense debuff, actual nut. And 6-6 deals a lightning strike equal to Razor's attack as electro damage. That's free damage, we take those. Alright, so how can we ramp his damage even more? Party compositions is really important, man. Again, there's two build compositions you can do with Razor. The physical comp, or the electro damage comp. So for the physical one, the standard team would be two electro units, including Razor, a cryo unit, and an Anemo. Double electro gives you a buff that gives you more energy recharge, but to be honest, Razor doesn't even need help recharging, okay? He has his sigils. Razor is so good by himself, he doesn't really need all that energy recharge, which is why, in my opinion, for pure damage build, I would recommend Razor, double cryo, and Anemo. Why double cryo? Because two cryo units gives a party buff of 15% crit if under cryo debuff, and that is massive in a crit build. Also, why cryo units? Because the reaction from cryo and electro is superconduct, which reduces physical defense by 50%. That is a literal must-have for physical teams. For an electro type build, you can also go two electro units, a fire unit, and then an Anemo. You don't need the superconduct proc, which reduces physical damage because you're in an electro build, so you can focus on other stuff like elemental reactions with overload and other stuff like that. So in Abyss Spiral, I'm around floor 10 and I'm only AR 35, and Razor basically carries the entire team. All I do is just buff him up, use super conduct with Venti and Kea, and then basically Razor just murders everyone on the team. Sometimes Abyss Spiral has the electro units as well. That's why I love the basic attack build, the physical build, with Razor so much. You can just whip out basic attacks and it'll be hitting for like 4k, 6k, and sometimes Aminus will hit for like 12k on crit damage procs. And I believe this is the best artifact choices for Razor. Remember, you want to stack crit damage as end game build. So if you hear anyone saying, oh, you gotta stack triple attack percent, you know they're completely wrong. I'll be going over a video of why it's wrong in the future. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe. I'm gonna be start doing Genshin Impact videos for the content creator contest that's coming up. So please support your boy. But thanks so much for watching. Until next time.